Hello learners, I am Mohini Arora and I welcome you to this session on operating systems, which is for the students of computer science course. In this session, we will be covering about operating systems, about types of operating systems. So let us begin the session. I hope you will learn, you will enjoy this session and it will be a gaining experience for you. So we begin with objectives of this session. In this session, we will be defining an operating system, we will be listing the functions of an operating system and we will be classifying the operating system into various types. So first of all, what is an operating system? As you all know, it is a software. An operating system is a software. It is a software which forms an interface between the user and the computer. It mediates between you when you work on the computer and between the hardware of the computer. So it controls the allocation of resources, it controls the memory management of the computer. Any command that you give to the computer, then that is first accessed by the operating system and then the respective functioning takes place, whether the output is to be given or whether the memory has to be allocated or any peripheral device has to be given any instructions. All such things are managed by the operating system. So let's see the main functions of the operating system. We have listed out 4-5 functions. First one is the process management. Now a process is a program, a task that is in execution state. Like I give a command and that command is being executed by the computer. So that execution time is the process that is being undertaken by the computer. So operating system is responsible for creation, deletion and scheduling of various processes that are being given to the computer by you as a user. At any point of time, a single process might be running on the system or multiple processes might be running on the system. Next function that we'll be discussing is memory management. Memory management, your computer is meant to store data. So to store any type of data, memory has to be allocated to the computer. So the operating system keeps track of every memory location that is either assigned to the computer or that is to be used by any of the devices for any job completion by the computer. It also checks how much memory should be assigned to each process for its successful completion. We move on to the next function of the operating system, that is the input-output management. A computer consists of input and output devices. We have done that. You know that there are various devices connected to the computer. So the operating system manages the input and output process of the computer as well. It responds to the user keystrokes, mouse clicks and other input formats. It may be in the form of touch screen or audio or video or images. Any input that is given to the computer is being taken care of by the operating system for processing purposes. The operating system also interprets any input-output requests that are requested so that adequate functions could be performed by the computer. So the third function of the operating system is input-output management of the computer. Next, file and disk management. Any information that you want to store on the computer is stored in the form of files. So any file has to be allocated memory on the computer. So operating system is responsible for allocating spaces for files on secondary storage media. I want to store my file on a CD, on a hard disk, on any other storage media. So the operating system takes care of that. Then next, if the file is of large size, then it has to be broken down into small fragments. So keeping the track of those fragments, where those fragments are being stored, which fragment is being brought to the primary memory for the active reading, all these things are also managed by the operating system. If the file is of smaller size, then it is stored in a contiguous fashion, but if a file is of larger size, then it has to be broken down into small fragments, and then each fragment has to be processed according to the job that is to be performed. So, this file and disk management is also controlled by the operating system. Next, we move on to user interface. As I discussed before, that an operating system is an interface that acts between you and your computer and your hardware. So, there are two types of user interfaces. One is text user interface or command line interface, and another is the graphical user interface. If I talk about the text user interface, it is a pure text. You must have seen some systems or some old systems where you type in the command. Every command has to be typed. It's on the command prompt, and then according to the command that you give to the computer and press enter key, then the respective process, the respective task is performed. So, that is the text user interface. The means of input is only the keyboard, the text. Moving on to graphical user interface, Windows, where I can give the input through the keyboard, through the mouse, and nowadays there are other devices also, through the scanner, through the touch screen, through the joystick. So, it forms an environment that is more user friendly to work with. So, that is the graphic user interface. If I talk about examples, then your DOS, your Unix is a CLI or a text user interface, whereas your Windows, your Linux, your OpenOffice operating systems, these are the graphical user interface. So, this slide compares the text user interface versus the graphic user interface. Obviously, text user interface is difficult to use as the commands have to be remembered, to be typed in, and if there is some error in the command, then the respective command will not be executed. On the other hand, a graphic user interface is easy to use. Next, the slide talks about control. A text user interface has more control over the operating system as compared to the graphic user interface. In fact, in case of graphic user interface, for performing certain advanced functions, you still need the command line. You still have to go to the DOS prompt to type few commands. For example, pinging, you have to go to the command prompt to ping and give that particular command. So, the more control on the operating system is by the text user interface. Then we have compared on the basis of resources. Your text user interface requires very few resources because the input is only through the keyboard, whereas the graphic user interface requires number of resources. You need the keyboard for text input, the mouse for clicking. You also have the option of scanning an image or recording an audio or a video. So, different resources are required in case of graphic user interface than in case of text user interface. And the examples that are given on your slide, Unix and DOS, are examples of text user interface, whereas Windows, Macintosh, Linux, all these are examples of graphic user interface. Next, we move on to types of operating system. In this session, we have covered Microsoft Windows, we have covered Unix, Linux, and smartphone operating systems. We start with Microsoft Windows operating system. As discussed before, Microsoft Windows operating system is a graphic user interface. That means it has an environment through which we can give input in various forms, in form of text, using keyboard, in form of mouse, using clicking, or in form of audio or video. So, and several programs can be opened at the same time. You must have used Windows operating system where I can work on MS Word, minimize that, and I can play a song also side by side. I can open an Excel spreadsheet or a Windows Explorer program. So, it supports multi-programming and multitasking. You can hear to the song in the background and keep on working on your presentation or your Word document. That is what is Microsoft Windows, a very, very popular operating system since decades, launched by Microsoft. Moving on to Linux. Linux is an open source operating system. When I talk about open source operating system, that means I am also given the code of the operating system to modify or distribute or edit it. So it becomes more approachable to me as a user. I can use it as in the manner I want. So Linux is falls in the category of operating systems which is openly available, freely available, and it is one of the first operating systems that was the open source operating systems available. It provides two types of graphic user interface. One is called KDE, another is called GNOME. Both are available. You may use it, you may, as per your requirement, you may choose any of the GUIs and you can work on that. We talk about now the three main components of Linux. It has three main components: kernel, system library, and system utility. Kernel is the core part of the Linux. It has the commands, it has got the functioning which helps in major activities of the operating system. So we can say that it is the brain, it's the core of the operating system, Linux operating system. It has got certain features which can be accessed by the system library, the second component of Linux. The system library has special functions using which the key features of the kernel can be accessed. And talking about the third component of Linux, the system utility, this particular component is responsible for performing specialized tasks that are to be performed by the operating system. So these are the three main components of Linux operating system. Then we talk about Unix, text user interface operating system, which is a very strong operating system is Linux, which is used to perform multiple tasks, multiple processes at the same point of time. It is a multi-user operating system. It can be used for servers, for desktops, for laptops. In fact, Linux is the advanced version of Unix only. So Unix has built-in security and permission features that even better than what Windows has. And the popular versions of Unix are Sun Solaris and Mac OS X, which can work on Unix. Then we move on smartphone operating system. These days, we are quite used to the smartphone operating systems. Each of us have seen a smartphone. A smartphone is one which is having the internet facility along with it. So three types of operating system are discussed here as far as the smartphones are concerned. One is the iOS, second is the Android, and third is the Windows phone. So we take them one by one. iOS operating system is by Apple Incorporation and it is a multi-touch, multitasking operating system. It runs on all Apple devices, Apple iPhone, Apple iPad, Apple iPod, and it comes with a Safari web browser. You must have seen the Safari web browser for internet access. It has iTunes app for music and mail app for accessing emails. These are very few features that the iOS operating system has. There are many, many more features available nowadays. As the version of the operating system increases, the features also keep on increasing. So we have just briefed about simple features that the iOS has. Next, we move on to Android operating system. Android operating system is owned by Google. And it is available on various devices, various mobile phones. It has millions of free apps available. Android even has a platform, a free platform for developing apps. If you want to develop your app, you can develop on the Android platform and test it. It is one of the most commonly used operating systems that you can see on various smartphones. Various companies are taking Android operating system for their smartphones. So it's a very, very popular smartphone operating systems that we see today. Next, we move on to Windows phone. As Windows, you must have seen as an operating system on the desktop, on the laptop. But same interface Windows has tried to create for the smartphones, for the mobile phones also. As on desktop, we have a tiled interface. Similarly, on Windows Phone operating system also, it has a tiled interface. It has home screen resembles the Windows desktop, and it comes with Internet Explorer as the browser in the same manner as you see on your desktop. And it comes with Microsoft Exchange for secure emails that you can access through your smartphones. Again, these are very few features listed here. It has got many more features available. There are other apps that you can run on Windows operating system. So that is what is a Windows operating system. So this brings us to the end of this session. And in this session, we have learnt about the operating system. What is an operating system? We have learnt about different functions performed by the operating system. It is file management, process management, memory management, input-output management. So all these functions are performed by the operating system. You need to have an operating system before installing any other software on your computer. The first thing that you need to install is the operating system. It forms the base, the platform on which other applications can run. And finally, we talked about different types of operating system. We talked about Windows, we talked about Unix, Linux, and smartphone operating system. In smartphone operating system, we discussed about iOS, about Android, and about Windows Phone. I hope this session was a learning experience for you and you gained knowledge on operating system. Thank you.
हिंदुस्तान के हर कोने में नौजवानों के पास प्रतिभा है, उन्हें अवसर चाहिए।
NIOS देता रहा है युवाओं को अवसर आगे बढ़ने का। NIOS से पढ़ने वाले इन युवाओं ने किया है संस्थान को गौरवान्वित। दिव्यांगों ने बनके दिखाया है सबल और आत्मनिर्भर NIOS के साथ। आप भी जुड़िए NIOS के संग।
प्रकाशित करने राहों को आलोकित करने
हम अपना दीपक स्वयं बने हम अपना रास्ता स्वयं चुने जीवन ये प्रकाशित करने राहों को आलोकित करने कभी पढ़े हम कहीं पढ़े वे विषय की लोच से युक्त हो
कभी पढ़े हम कहीं पढ़े वे विषय की लोच से युक्त हो
मित्रों हम उठे और जागे ये प्रकाशित करने राहों को आलोकित करने
राष्ट्रीय मोक्ष
बार ही क्यों मिलता फिर दुनिया में इसके केंद्र बात
कोई मन चाहा केंद्र चुने हम अपना जीवन स्वयं बने हम अपना रास्ता स्वयं चुने कोई मन चाहा केंद्र चुने
हिंदुस्तान के हर कोने में नौजवानों के पास प्रतिभा है, उन्हें अवसर चाहिए।
NIOS देता रहा है युवाओं को अवसर आगे बढ़ने का। NIOS से पढ़ने वाले इन युवाओं ने किया है संस्थान को गौरवान्वित। दिव्यांगों ने बनके दिखाया है सबल और आत्मनिर्भर। NIOS के साथ आप भी जुड़िए। NIOS के संग
पच्चीस साल का लंबा सफर और लाखों लोगों के चेहरों पर खिलती मुस्कान, गर्व और गरिमा से जीने की प्रेरणा देती मुस्कान, आत्मसम्मान और विश्वास से पैदा हुई मुस्कान, इन खिलते चेहरों पर ये मुस्कान आई है शिक्षा के जरिए। ये मुस्कान आई है नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ ओपन स्कूलिंग यानी NIOS के जरिए। नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ ओपन स्कूलिंग या राष्ट्रीय मुक्त विद्यालयी शिक्षा संस्थान, इस संस्थान का एक बड़ा उद्देश्य है आम आदमियों के जीवन को बेहतर बनाना। ऐसे लोग जिनके लिए शिक्षा एक दूर का सपना है, या वे बच्चे जो परिवार की रोजी रोटी कमाने के लिए बीच में ही स्कूल छोड़ने पर मजबूर हो जाते हैं। NIOS ऐसे बच्चों और बड़ों को दोबारा शिक्षा से जुड़ने का मौका मुहैया कराता है ताकि वे एक बेहतर जीवन जी सके। 1989 में स्थापना के बाद NIOS ने देश के लाखों बच्चों और वयस्कों को बेहतर शिक्षा से जोड़ा है। इनमें हर उम्र, हर पृष्ठभूमि, हर जाति, हर मजहब और हर क्षेत्र के लड़के लड़कियां, महिलाएं और पुरुष शामिल हैं। बड़ई से लेकर पायलट, डॉक्टर, इंजीनियर, बेकर और दर्जी तक, NIOS कोशिश कर रहा है सबको शिक्षित और सशक्त बनाने की, चाहे वो असम के दूर दराज इलाके में रहने वाला हो या फिर मुंबई जैसे महानगर का। NIOS ने अपनी मौजूदगी हर जगह दर्ज कराई है। NIOS ने शिक्षा की परंपरागत सोच को ही बदल दिया है। वो पढ़िए जो हम पढ़ाते हैं की जगह NIOS की नई सोच है, हम वो पढ़ाते हैं जो आप पढ़ना चाहते हैं। इस नई सोच ने लोगों को आगे बढ़ने और NIOS के साथ जुड़ने के लिए प्रोत्साहित किया है। शिक्षा उपलब्ध कराने के मामले में NIOS किसी सीमा को नहीं मानता, उम्र की सीमा को भी नहीं। चंडीगढ़ के गणेश के लिए भी NIOS एक वरदान साबित हुआ। NIOS शारीरिक रूप से अक्षम बच्चों को भी बेहतर शिक्षा मुहैया कराने के लिए पूरी तरह प्रतिबद्ध है। ऐसे बच्चों के लिए शिक्षा न केवल रोजगार के द्वार खोलती है बल्कि उन्हें आत्मविश्वास और गर्व के साथ जीना भी सिखाती है। NIOS खेल के इन सितारों को उनकी सुविधा और समय के अनुसार बेहतर शिक्षा उपलब्ध कराता है। मेरी कॉम, सोमदेव देववर्मन, देविका रिबेका पल्लिकल, अरमान इब्राहिम, प्रद्युमन प्रकाश और अमय ज्योत सिंह, NIOS सीमा पर खड़े उन प्रहरियों को भी शिक्षा से लाभान्वित करता है जो देश की सुरक्षा के लिए अपनी जान की बाजी लगाने से भी नहीं चूकते। सच तो ये है कि NIOS की पहुंच हर ओर रहती है, चाहे वो दूर दराज के आदिवासी हो या जेल की कोठरी में बंद कैदी या फिर ग्रामीण और शहरी क्षेत्रों के गरीब निवासी, देश में कहीं भी कोई भी व्यक्ति, स्त्री, पुरुष, लड़का, लड़की, अमीर, गरीब, शिक्षा से वंचित न रहे। राष्ट्रीय मुक्त विद्यालय शिक्षा संस्थान का यही मिशन है।
राष्ट्रीय मुक्त विद्यालय शिक्षा संस्थान पूरे देश में शिक्षा के साथ साथ कौशल विकास के क्षेत्र में बहुत सारे कोर्सेज दे रहा है। लगभग 100 से ज़्यादा कोर्सेज हैं। हम दूर दराज के गांव में अपने संस्थान बनाते हैं और वहां के बच्चों को, वहां के बच्चियों को, वहां के वयस्कों को हुनर के क्षेत्र में शिक्षा पहुँचाते हैं। आपको जानकर खुशी होगी कि अब हम आर्ट, साइंस, कॉमर्स जिन क्षेत्रों में 12वीं का सर्टिफिकेट दिया जाता रहा है, अब हम हुनर के क्षेत्र में, वोकेशनल एरिया में भी 10वीं और 12वीं का सर्टिफिकेशन करेंगे। तो वो बच्चे जो कृषि से जुड़े हुए हैं, कारपेंट्री से जुड़े हुए हैं या दूसरे क्षेत्रों से जुड़े हुए हैं, वो अपने ही क्षेत्र में काम करेंगे, सीखेंगे, हुनर पैदा करेंगे अपने में और सर्टिफाइड भी होंगे कि वो सर्टिफाइड कृषक हैं, खेतिहर हैं। तो आज तक जो हमारे देश में ये सोच रही है कि आप 12वीं पास तभी कहे जाएंगे जब भूगोल, अर्थशास्त्र, भौतिकी ये पढ़ेंगे, अब ये समय बदल गया है। ITI में जितने बच्चे पढ़ते हैं, लगभग 18 लाख बच्चे हर साल दाखिला लेते हैं, अब हम उनको सर्टिफिकेशन करेंगे।
NIOS अपने छात्रों को माध्यमिक स्तर पर 26 और उच्च माध्यमिक स्तर पर 19 विषयों का विकल्प देता है। पढ़ाई किस माध्यम से करनी है, इसमें भी आपको लचीलापन मिलेगा। माध्यमिक स्तर पर ही 7 भाषाओं के अलग अलग माध्यमों का विकल्प मौजूद है। शैक्षणिक कार्यक्रमों के अलावा 86 वोकेशनल शिक्षा कार्यक्रम भी उपलब्ध हैं, जो छात्रों को कामकाजी दुनिया के लिए तैयार करते हैं। वोकेशनल प्रशिक्षण को अधिक सुदृढ़ बनाने के लिए NIOS ने ITDC, सिस्को, इंडियन मेडिकल एसोसिएशन जैसे कई सरकारी और गैर सरकारी संस्थानों के साथ भागीदारी स्थापित की है। आज लाखों छात्रों के लिए अपनी पसंद का स्कूल है राष्ट्रीय मुक्त विद्यालयी शिक्षा संस्थान यानी नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ ओपन स्कूलिंग। NIOS ने एक लंबा सफर तय किया है, लेकिन मंजिल अभी दूर है। निरंतर विकास और नवीनीकरण के लिए NIOS सदैव प्रतिबद्ध है। शिक्षा का उद्देश्य महज रोजगार जुटाना ही नहीं है, बल्कि स्वयं को सशक्त बनाना भी है। NIOS लाखों छात्रों के लिए यही आत्मसम्मान दिलाने में जुटा है। लाखों लोगों के लिए एक आशा और उम्मीद है नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ ओपन स्कूलिंग। शिक्षा सबके लिए, कहीं भी, कभी भी।
हिंदुस्तान के हर कोने में नौजवानों के पास प्रतिभा है, उन्हें अवसर चाहिए।
NIOS देता रहा है युवाओं को अवसर आगे बढ़ने का। NIOS से पढ़ने वाले इन युवाओं ने किया है संस्थान को गौरवान्वित। दिव्यांगों ने बन के दिखाया है सबल और आत्मनिर्भर। NIOS के साथ आप भी जुड़िए। NIOS के संग।